Hello students, welcome to my lecture number 13 of part 2 chapter 6 cash flow statements. This is the second lecture of unit number 6. In previous lecture we have discussed what is cash flow, what is cash inflow, what is cash outflow, then how many activities are covered under the head cash flow statements. In that we have started the first activity, that is operating activity, right? And we have completed the format of operating activity and one sum related to operating activity. Today we'll do another sums related to operating activities, right? So page 285, question number 15. From the following transaction, calculate cash flow from operating activities. So, first of all, we'll give the head cash flow from operating activity. Right? So, in format, you know that first comes profit before tax, then comes less non-operating incomes, then comes add non-cash expense, provisions and financial expense. Right? So, after that, the answer which we'll get, that is known as profit before changes in working capital. Then we have to add decrease in current assets and increase in current liabilities. Then we have to less increase in current assets and decrease in current liability. And the answer we'll get, from that we have to deduct income tax paid. And the final answer is known as cash flow from operating activities. Right? So, first we'll write the main head. First main head is profit before tax. Then from that we have to less non-operating income. For that we'll leave 4 to 5 lines. Then will add non-cash expense, provisions and financial expenses. Right? So, first one, the information is profit before tax, amount is 99,000. That we have to write in second column, 99,000. Then comes income tax provision. See, they have used the word income tax provision, provision word. Provision comes in this head. So, we'll write here income tax provision. Amount is 29,000. That we have to write in the first column of amount. Then comes proposed dividend, that is also proposed. That means we have only created the provision. So it will come here, proposed dividend, 39,000. Then comes depreciation, that is our non-cash expense, right? Depreciation, amount 22,000. Then dividend received and interest received. See, dividend and interest received, that means they both are our income, but non-operating income. That's why they will come here, dividend received and income, sorry, interest received. Amount 21,000 and 20,000. 21,000 and 20,000. Next one is interest paid, that is financial expense, goodwill written off, non-cash expense. Then profit on sale of assets, that is non-operating income. That means there will only one income left, right? So I am writing this head up, okay? Profit on sale of investment, sale of assets, 12,000. Other 2 points I can cover in this sum, that's why I am writing this here, okay? I'm just repeating it, so no, you don't have to do anything in your book. And non-cash expense, provisions, and financial expense. Interest paid, that will come here, interest paid, amount is 28,000. Then comes goodwill written off, that is also non-cash expense, goodwill written off, amount is 15,000, right? So we have write down all the information. Now what we have to do, first of all we have to do total of non-operating income, then we have to do total of non-cash expense, provisions and financial expense. So the total of non-operating income is 53,000. See here, one line in space. So here you have to write 99,000 minus 53,000 and our answer will be 46,000, right? Now we have to do total of non-cash expense, provisions and financial expense, and this total is 1,33,000. This we have to add, right? So 46,000 plus 1,33,000, 1,79,000. This is our answer, right? So this is the answer of profit before changes in working capital. You know what is working capital? Working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. Write it down. Complete. the sum, page number 264, illustration number 6. From the following information of Ami Company, calculate cash flow from operating activities. They have given information of 2 years. First is 31,317 and second one is 31,316. 31,317 means end of the year, and 31,316, that is opening. That means they have given both the balances, opening balance as well as closing balance, right? So first of all, we'll draw the statement. Our head is cash flow from operating activity. Particulars, amount. First one is profit and loss account. That means this is the profit. The closing balance of P&L is 89,000 and opening balance is 64,000, right? So first of all, we have to do closing balance of P&L account minus opening balance of P&L account. And by this, the answer which we'll get, that is known as profit of current year, right? So amount of closing balance is 89,000 and opening balance is 64,000. So the profit of current year will be 25,000, right? Now, you know, first of all, we have to less non-operating income and then we have to add non-cash expense, provisions and financial expense. Right? So first one is general reserve. General reserve is our provision. So see, the balance, the closing balance is 34,000 and opening balance is 18,000. So it has been increased. We have made some provisions during the year. So the general reserve will come here. Closing balance minus opening balance, 34,000 minus 18,000, and our answer will be 16,000. Right? Next one, taxation provision. See, here they give taxation provision, two amounts. When in the question they have given closing balance and opening balance, we have to write only closing balance in provisions. The opening balance of taxation provision will come in last as minus taxes paid, right? So right now I am writing only taxation provision. Taxation provision. But which amount? Only closing balance. in tax, there is a only this method that you have to write closing balance here and opening balance in the last. In others, for example, in general reserve, then dividend, you have to write closing balance minus opening balance and the answer. So the total closing balance is 22,000. Here I don't have space to write tax paid. That's why we'll write after rough everything. Okay. So next one is depreciation. See, closing balance is 28,000 and opening balance is 16,000. That means we have made this year depreciation. So depreciation closing balance 28,000 minus opening balance 16,000 and our answer is 12,000. Next one, goodwill. In the beginning, so that is 19,000 and at the end of the year 15,000. That means we have written off the goodwill. So this will come here, goodwill written off, closing balance, sorry, opening balance, that is 19,000 minus 15,000, 4,000. During the year, goodwill has been decreased. Then debtors, creditors, bills receivable and bills payable. This four thing will come after finding profit from working capital, right? So first of all, we'll do total of this two. See, in this sum they have not given any non-operating income. That's why we'll write dash. So 25,000, answer is also 25,000. Then we have to do total of non-cash expense, provisions and financial expense. And the total of this four is 54,000. Now we have to add 25,000 plus 54,000 and our answer will be 79,000, right? So this answer 79,000, that is known as profit before changes in working capital. The sum is not completed yet. First of all, write this, then we'll continue. Okay, write down. See, we get the answer of profit before changes in working capital. Now, the next step of this format is we have to add what? Decrease in current assets and increase in current liability, right? Then we have to less this, you have to write in blue pen. Okay, then less increase, opposite of this, decrease in current assets we are adding, then we have to subtract increase in current assets. Increase in current liabilities we are adding, then we have to deduct decrease in current liabilities. So, see, they have given debtors. Debtors are our current assets. So, see, the closing balance is 38,000 and opening balance is 18,000. So, there is increase in current assets. Our debtors were of 18,000, but in opening and at the end of the year, the amount is 38,000. So, our debtors are increased. So, instead of writing increase in current assets, I will write increase in debtors. Right? Because debtors are our current assets. And the amount is 38 minus 18. Then next, creditors. At the beginning of the year, creditors were rupees 22,000 and at the end of the year it becomes 45. So there is increase. Creditors are our current liability. So increase in current liability, that it will come here. So instead of writing current liabilities, I will write creditors here. Creditors. Amount 45 minus 22. 45,000 minus 22,000. Answer is 23,000. Then next, bills receivable. Bills receivable are our current assets, but at the beginning of the year that was 12,000. But in the end of the year, that becomes 8,000. So there is decrease in bills receivable. So decrease in current assets, we have to write here. So instead of writing current assets, I am writing bills receivable. Amount. Opening was 12,000 and closing was 8,000. See, here we are finding increase and decrease. So no need to write closing and opening. Answer is 4,000. And last one, that is bills payable. Bill payables are our current liabilities. In the beginning of the year, the amount of bills payable is 15,000. And at the end of the year, that becomes 9,000. So there is decrease in bills payable. So we can say that there is decrease in current liability. Instead of writing current liabilities, we'll write bills payable. The amount was 15,000 and now it becomes 9,000. So 6,000 will come here. Now we have to do total of both this. 23,000 plus 4,000, 27,000. So 79,000 minus plus those 27,000. And our answer will be 1,07,000. In the next column we'll write this amount. So there will be one line space between this two and this two, so that we can write the total of them. Then 20,000 plus 6,000, 26,000. This 26,000 we have to subtract from 1,07,000 and we'll get the answer. So answer is 1,06,000. So we'll get the answer, that is 80,000. Right? See, now only one thing is left, that is taxation provision. I told you that taxation provision has only different effect, others have same effect. In taxation provision, if they have given both the balance, opening and closing, then you have to write closing balance here and opening balance as less taxation or tax paid. In others, you have to find the difference between opening and closing. But in taxation provision only, you have to write closing balance here and opening balance here. Opening balance is 23,000. So you have to subtract 23,000 from 80,000 and you will get the answer 57,000. And this answer is known as cash flow from operating activities. Right? So this is the full-fledged sum of operating activities, right? We have completed two sums before completing this sum. That was not full-fledged sum, but this is the full-fledged sum of operating activities, right? Write it down. Complete. Let's do another sum. Page 265, illustration number 7. Draw a format of one page in your file book. Illustration number 7. From the following information and balance sheet of 2 years of Nirav Company, calculate cash flow from operating activities. They have given the year here, right? That's why we have to write cash flow from operating activity for the year ending on 31,370. They have given equity and liabilities in that share capital. Share capital is not operating activity. That's why will not give any effect of share capital. So cross there. Then profit and loss account. Yes. Profit and loss account, the balance of opening and closing that we have to write, because that is our operating activities. So first of all, I will write closing balance of P&L account less opening balance of P&L account. Closing amount is 4,50,000. And opening amount is 3 lakh. So 4,50,000 and 3 lakh. Our answer will be 1,50,000. So this is the profit of current year. Right? Then we have to less non-operating income, right? See, is there any non-operating income in the question? No, there is not any income, non-operating income, right? That's why I am not giving any space here, and directly write add non-cash expense provisions and financial expense, right? So we have completed till the first information, that is first main head, shareholders fund. Next one is 12% debentures. Debentures are our financial activity. That's why will not write debenture activities here. But see, in the additional information, they have given the second thing, that is, new debentures are issued at the end of the year. They have used the percentage 12% debentures. That means during a year we are paying 12% interest on those debentures. But we have to pay debentures interest on opening balance. Why? See, because in the opening the amount was 2 lakh, in the closing amount was 3 lakh. So during the year they have issued 1 lakh rupees debenture, but on which date? On, see, in that information is given in additional information. New debentures are issued at the end of the year. That means just now we have issued new debentures, so we don't have to pay interest on those debenture right now. That amount will pay in next year. So right now we have to pay interest on debenture of only 2 lakh. So 2 lakh into 12%, the rate of interest on debenture will be 24,000, and debenture interest, that is our financial expense. So we have to write here debenture interest total amount 2 lakh, and per year interest rate is 12%. So this amount will become 24,000. Next, that is bank overdraft. Bank overdraft is not related to cash. Why? The overdraft related expense is done within the business, right? Due to bank overdraft, cash will not increase or cash will not decrease. That's why there is no effect of bank overdraft, right? So next one, that is creditors. Creditors will come under the head and after changes in working capital, right? So creditors closing balance is 60,000 and opening balance is 90,000. So we can say that there is decrease in creditors. Creditors are our liability. So first of all, I will write, after leaving four to five lines, I am writing, we have to add decrease in current assets and increase in current liabilities, right? And then comes total of this. So we have to leave one line, then we have to write less increase in current assets and decrease in current liabilities, right? But right now we'll not write. First of all, we'll complete this so that I can rough and then we'll explain, okay? Because I don't have space. So creditors, do a tick mark because we have not given any effect of that right now. Then comes proposed dividend amount 50,000 and 30,000. There is no effect of dividend of opening balance, right? So we don't have to give any effect of opening balance of dividend. We have to give only the effect of closing balance of dividend. So we'll write proposed dividend because that is our provisions. Proposed dividend into bracket closing balance amount is 50,000 . Next taxation provision, closing balance and opening balance. Closing balance we have to write here taxation provision but which amount closing balance? Opening balance will come in the last. So closing balance is of 50,000. Please also do tick mark in taxation provision too. So that is, in equity and liability side, two effects are left to give in this sum. The first one is effect of creditors and second one is effect of opening balance of taxation, right? Then comes assets. First main head, non-current assets, in that fixed assets, tangible assets and intangible assets. See, fixed assets, that means non-current assets that will come under the head investing activities, not in the head operating activities. That's why will not give any effect of non-current assets, will give direct effect of current assets. See, they have given current assets closing balance 2 lakh, opening balance 3 lakh. That means there is decrease in current assets, right? In the beginning the amount was 3 lakh, in the end 2 lakh. So there is decrease of 1 lakh in current assets, right? Now we'll do total. There is not a single income, right? See, one additional information is left. We have given the effect of second additional information, but the first effect is left. Interim dividend paid. We have paid dividend, right? Amount is 20,000. So this will come here because dividend paid, that is our financial expense. We'll write interim dividend paid. Amount is 20,000. Right? So total is 1,50,000. Then from that we have to add 50,000, 50,000, 24,000 and 20,000. The total of them is 1,44,000. Right? Just a second. 1,44,000. Now we have to add 1,50,000 plus 1,44,000, and our answer will be 2,94,000. Okay. Then there is decrease in current assets of 1 lakh. This we have to add. So the answer will be 3,94,000. That still we have not completed this answer. 2 lakh sum is incomplete, right? This 2,94,000, that is profit before changes in working capital. First complete this. After this we have to less, then we have to less interest, income tax paid, then our answer will be complete. Okay, so write down this. Complete. See, after this effect, the next thing which will come, that is less. What? Here we have a decrease in current assets. That means we have to less increase in current assets. And here we have a increase in current liabilities. So here we have to less decrease in current liabilities, right? So we have done tick mark in two things, creditors and taxation provision. Creditors are of 90,000 in opening balance and 60,000 in closing. So there is decrease in current liabilities. So into break, you can love the current liabilities and write decrease in creditors, and you can write creditors in bracket. Amount is 90,000 in the beginning and 60,000 in the end. 90,000 minus 60,000. Answer will be 30,000. So 3,94,000 plus minus 30,000. Our answer will be 3,64,000. After giving effect of this, we have to less income tax paid. That means opening balance of taxation provision, and that amount is 40,000. That we have to write in second column, and the final answer will get, that is 3,24,000. This is the answer of cash flow from operating activities. Right? Here the sum is completed. Start writing. Next thing, that is your homework. Your homework is illustration number 8 and illustration number 9. Right? Both the sums are same as illustration number 5 and 6, right? So in next lecture we'll do another sums of operating activities. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take care.